Hello and welcome to Data-Driven Web Apps in Pyramid. In this course, we are going to take the Pyramid Web Framework, which is a Python-based web framework. And we're going to build some amazing data-driven web applications. We're going to use Bootstrap, which is one of the most popular CSS front-end design frameworks to make our web app we build in Python look great. Of course, almost all web applications access databases, at least the dynamic ones do. We're going to use the most popular and powerful Python-based ORM called SQLAlchemy to write Python classes and map those to our database. Welcome, welcome, welcome to Data-Driven Web Apps in Pyramid. We're going to have a great time building some real-world applications and learning some real-world ways to put them into production. In this course, you're going to learn what's sometimes referred to as full-stack web development. Now, we don't spend that much time on the JavaScript side of things, but everything else we do spend a fair amount of time on. So what the heck is full stack anyway? Let's look at all the pieces involved in a typical web application interaction. We have a browser, we have our server running out on some cloud hosting, we have usually a virtual machine or set of virtual machines in the background, and our database we're working with. So a request is going to come in, it's going to magically find its way through the internet to our server. Our server is going to do some processing, talk to the database, and so on. Where's the full stack part come in? Well, let's look at the technologies involved here. On the server side, there are a bunch of different technologies you need to learn. We're going to learn Python. Well, we're going to use Python at least, and we'll probably learn a little bits of it along the way, but we're going to focus on using Python along with Pyramid, the web framework that we're going to work with, the dynamic HTML templates, in this case, Chameleon, the data access layer, SQLAlchemy. In order to deploy and configure our servers, we're going to need to know a little bit of Linux, learn that. We're going to use Nginx and MicroWSGI. These are two cooperating web servers that we're going to work with to run our Python code in Pyramid. Then we're going to talk to the database. Well, what do you need to know for that? Well, maybe this is Postgres or MongoDB. For the course, we're actually going to use SQLite and also a little bit of touch of MongoDB at the end, but it's easier to switch to something like Postgres. You may need to know the query language to get to that, like SQL or MongoDB's query syntax. It's like a JSON type thing. We're not going to actually focus much on the query syntax because we're going to use SQLAlchemy, which lets us sort of abstract that away. But you would more or less need to know that in practice. And then you also need to know how to migrate or manage your database over time as its structure changes. Look at all these technologies just on the server side. Well, that's a lot to learn. And this whole stack of technologies put together is part of what's called full stack, but there's more to it. Over here on the browser side, we have HTML and CSS we have to deliver to the browser, right? That's ultimately the goal, is to show stuff on the screen for the web browser. So HTML, CSS, we're going to do some work with that. You typically don't want to do the design from scratch, so you'll pick a front-end framework like Bootstrap. Maybe you're even writing some rich JavaScript apps with, say, Vue.js. Those are grayed out because, like I said, we're not doing much with JavaScript, but these are the technologies that you might put into play for a full-stack web application. The web can be a little bit daunting. We're going to go through most of these technologies, all of the white highlighted ones in this course, and you'll have concrete small examples for each one. And in the end, we'll have it all put together in a full stack Python-based web app using Pyramid, SQLAlchemy, and Bootstrap. In case you haven't already scanned the table of contents to figure out what we're going to cover, let's really quickly go through some of the topics that we're going to cover in this course. After this introduction section, we'll briefly cover what you need to set up your machine and the tools and editors you need to follow along. We're going to introduce the Pyramid Web Framework, some of its design principles, and compare and contrast it with other popular frameworks. We'll create our first site. Here's where we start writing code in this chapter 4. We're going to create our first site and get it up and running in Pyramid. We'll look at the various options for HTML templates, and then we'll dig deeper into the Chameleon template language. If you want to use another one, that would be totally fine, but I make a case for why I think this is the best HTML template language out there. We'll see that mapping URLs to methods in our web app is a central part of the MVC framework, the Model View Controller framework, that is Pyramid and popular among many of the Python web frameworks. So we'll focus on taking a URL and getting it to run a function and get some kind of response. Once we have some basic pages up and running, we'll look at how we make our pages beautiful. We'll bring in Bootstrap, also talk a little bit about some other front-end frameworks if you want to use something other than Bootstrap, but we'll look at Bootstrap and how to bring that into our web app. At this point, we'll have basic web app functionality happening, but it'll be based on fake in-memory data. Of course, we don't want fake in-memory data. We want live full-stack web apps. So we're going to move down a little bit in that stack towards the data access layer. We'll talk about SQLAlchemy, how the ORM works. We'll define classes that map our data into our database and, of course, run queries to get that data back. You'll see the SQLAlchemy ORM is great for creating the initial database structure, but if it changes, things are going to go crazy, right? Our database is going to be out of sync with our ORM classes, and you'll see that's a full-on crash. It's really, really bad. It's kind of hard to maintain this stuff. Well, Alembic, a database migration framework that's paired with SQLAlchemy, will come to the rescue. We can point Alembic at our SQLAlchemy classes and our database and go, we changed these, make the database scripts that are needed to do that change, to apply those changes automatically, just make that for us, and then we can apply that to, like, say, staging or production as we roll out new versions. It's going to be great. Once we have our database working, we'll want to accept user input, probably save it to the database as well. So we'll talk about HTML forms, letting users create accounts, register, enter data, that sort of thing. If you're accepting data, you had better be validating it, right? The internet is a harsh place, and lots of people try to send invalid data either by mistake or maliciously. We're going to talk about some really awesome design patterns called view models for server-side validation and data exchange. And then we'll also talk about leveraging some HTML5 features so we don't have to write any JavaScript for client-side validation. Testing web apps can be tricky because web applications depend upon things like databases and other services and the web framework itself, right? Like the request response model, all that. So we'll see that Pyramid provides special infrastructure to make it testable so that we can test our web application more easily without actually creating servers and doing heavyweight stuff like that. Once our app's built, tested, everything's working, it's time to ship it, right? Put it online. So we're going to take our web app and deploy it on a brand new Linux server out on the internet, and we'll have our web app running and live, and you'll see everything you need to do to take a bare Ubuntu image and get it up and running to be our web and database server. Finally, we're going to take a look back at how we built our application, how we've structured it so that we have a lot of flexibility using various design patterns for accessing the data and validating data and so on. And as an exercise, we're going to convert from a relational database to a MongoDB database. That's interesting. If you want to know about MongoDB, you'll see how to do that. But it's also interesting just to show how flexible these design patterns are, because we're going to make this conversion by just changing a few handful of files, even though there'll be many, many aspects of our site. We'll have that really isolated and focused, so it's super easy to do whatever we want with our data access. If you wanted to, say, convert it to calling web services in some kind of microservice architecture, you'd see the techniques we're using here for MongoDB would equally apply to that exact same transformation. This is what we're going to cover. I hope you find it super interesting. It's a real-world version of what you need to build and ship web applications. This is almost everything you need to know to go from, I know a little bit of Python and HTML, to running these full-stack web apps that are things like the trading site or YouTube or stuff like that. I hope you're excited to learn it. I'm definitely excited to share it with you. Now, before we get to the rest of the course, let me just quickly introduce myself. Hey, I'm Michael. Feel free to reach out to me on Twitter, where I'm at mkennedy. I've done a number of things in the Python space. One is create the Talk Python to Me podcast, where I've interviewed a lot of people involved in these various technologies. Mike Baer from SQLAlchemy, Chris McDonough, from the founder of Pyramid. I'll talk a little bit about some of those episodes when we get to the right place and how you can go learn more. But I started and run the Talk Python to Me podcast. I also run the Python Bytes podcast, which is sort of a news one. Check that out. And of course, I'm the founder and one of the main authors at Talk Python Training. Nice to meet you. I'm really excited to join my course. Now, let's get started.